I think we are all looking for some sense of normalcy right now, which is why I and my husband are so excited to hear that the NBA is restarting their season next month in a fanless bubble in Orlando. But some teams are already dealing with players testing positive, and Florida is obviously a hotbed for COVID right now. It's even been dubbed the new epicenter. Are you confident it's the safest place for your players?
Yes, absolutely. Look, no place is going to be absolutely safe. But we have taken every precaution, spoken to every epidemiologist, every scientist who we can hire. And they basically created an environment. I call it the Hotel California. You enter, but you don't leave until your team's eliminated. And what that's allowed us to do is make sure that our players are in the safest possible environment. And honestly, Megan, I think they're going to be safer there than they would be in Dallas or Milwaukee or L.A. or pick any other city.
Mm-hmm. Now, while the NBA is reportedly going to paint Black Lives Matter on the courts, they haven't signaled any willingness to reverse their nearly, I think, 40-year-old rule against kneeling during the national anthem. You defended that policy, Mark, in 2017, but now you say you do support players kneeling, and you'll kneel with players if the opportunity arises. What changed for you, and do you think players, even you, could be punished for kneeling?
We'll see what the NBA comes down in terms of the actual rules, but we're in a different time. Things are changing. The last 5 weeks, I've seen a dramatic shift in how people in this country are responding to systemic racism. And because we've seen such dramatic change, I want to be part of the solution. And you got to let go of the old ways that just were not working. And if that means going against the grain and maybe upsetting a few people, so be it. But if our guys want to kneel, I think that's a great step forward. Look, I'll add this. You know, all this discussion of kneeling and the flag has got me thinking again about the Pledge of Allegiance. And the best part about the Pledge of Allegiance is when you pledge allegiance to the flag for, you know, liberty and justice for all. And so I think players or anybody that addresses the flag and kneels really is just standing up for that pledge they made for liberty and justice for all, because that's truly what we need in this country. And if NBA players or any athletes anywhere can move us further in that direction, that's a beautiful thing.
You are absolutely right. We